Hello everyone, my name is Asia Saint Germain. I am Lactophone Ojibwe and Grand Traverse Band Odawa. Today we're here at the Native American Heritage Month Powwow here at UIC. So Powwow is basically where we gather to dance and to spend time with each other. What's going on today is we have three drums here today, and we have a couple dancers, and it's just a time for us to gather and to talk to each other, because I know there's a lot of people here that I haven't seen in a while.
It's a really good time. We get to meet a lot of other indigenous people. I've met people all over the country, all up into Canada, Hawaii, up into Alaska.
During the summer, I do this like every weekend, and it's nice to just like get away from home and not like go hang out with your friends and family, like not even like your real family. It could be like powwow family that you just meet every weekend and just like to hang out with.
I come here to honor my ancestors, those who are sick, my elders, and all of my relations. And the reason why we are here is not only to honor, but to pray for healing, to pray for unity, to pray for our future, and to be empowered with the presence of all of us, natives and non-natives, being together in unity.
People think that like when you go to powwows, you gotta be like invited or you gotta be like a special person. Powwows are just open to everybody. Traditional contest doesn't matter. You can come whenever you want. And like when they say intertribal, that means anybody can come out and dance. Doesn't matter what kind of race, if you even got regalia on or not, you can just come out and have a good time.
The thing is that it's really important for us to even be able to practice our culture freely, because it was under siege decades ago. We couldn't actually freely open, practice our cultures and religions. You know, our existence is the resistance of our ancestors, and we're still here, and we're in the present and not in the past.
We're all like just basically a big family pretty much, man. Like the whole entire tribe, like if you go down the reservation, like you go house to house, everybody knows each other. Everybody's like basically family there.
No matter what you've been through, they're always there to accept you. I got here 2 years ago and I met my aunts, and they've taught me really how to be kind, respectful, caring, even if I wasn't in certain times.
It's always nice to be able to meet other indigenous people around, you know, the Great Lakes and area and Turtle Island, and hear the stories that they have to tell, because I believe, you know, our traditions and teachings were more of came from an oral state. And that word of mouth, that moccasin trail that we travel along, that's how we spread, you know, those ceremonies and those teachings between our peoples.
So at the powwow, there's always a head lady and a head man. And for this particular powwow, I was asked to be head lady. The head lady and the head man starts off every dance, every song. We bring out the people, we let them know that it's cool to join in and stuff, and we kind of just keep everything together. We dance behind the veterans because it's a sign of respect. So it's just knowing what to do and how to do things.
People who do not know about us need to be open with their heart and their mind in order to learn something, because we are the original peoples of this land. We're all one, we're all related. We did not have borders before. We are all indigenous people. And you have to decolonize the mind in order to understand that we're all one people. And the thing that's so important is that we educate ourselves and listen to each other and rise up and stand in unity. And I think this is a great holding today where we're at the powwow here at UIC, because it gives us a voice.
We're still here.